In this video, we're going to look at acid-base titrations. And a titration is performed to neutralize an acid by a base, and the endpoint is found by the aid of an indicator. And acid-base titrations are a staple in the general chemistry laboratory. And the first calculation we're going to look at is going to involve a strong acid, strong base titration. And these titrations were introduced in Chapter 4, and we're going to start with these because it's a much simpler example. So we're going to have 25.00 milliliters of a 0.1 molar HCl solution versus 0.1 molar sodium hydroxide solution. So in this particular case, we're going to have HCl in aqueous solution plus NaOH, giving us NaCl plus water. And remember, when we have an acid-base neutralization reaction, we get a salt plus water. So what we're going to do here, and typically in titrations, we can set up a graph and we can monitor the pH versus the volume of base added. Okay, so if we look at the pH values here, we'll go 2, 4, 6, 8, and 10. We can monitor the change in pH versus the volume of the base. And we'll typically draw these little titration curves with this. So let's look at the various points in a graph that we could look at. Point number one is, what is the pH before any addition of NaOH? So our concentration of H plus in this case is going to be 0.1 molar, and that means if we take the negative log of that, our pH is going to equal 1. So before any base is added, our initial pH we can plot on this curve is going to be 1, because here's our volume of our base added. At 0, we're going to have a point of 1 for the pH. So the second scenario that we're going to look at here is, what is the pH after adding 24.00 milliliters of 0.1 molar NaOH? And this is going to be just before the endpoint. And our HCl is going to be in excess. So here we have HCl plus NaOH giving NaCl plus water. And in this case, we have 25.00 milliliters of HCl times 0.1 molar, and here we're going to have 24.00 milliliters of NaOH also at 0.1 molar. Okay, when we multiply molarity times milliliters, we can get millimoles. So here we're going to have 2.500 millimoles of HCl and 2.400 milliliters of NaOH. So that means that we're going to have 0.100 millimoles of HCl in excess divided by 49.00 milliliters, because that's going to be our combined volume. So when we divide millimoles per liter, that's the same as, or millimoles per milliliter is the same as moles per liter. So this gives us a concentration of 0.002 molar in HCl, which is equal to our H plus concentration, since HCl is a strong acid. And our pH here is going to equal 2.7. So if this is the volume of our base added, and we look at different volumes increments that we're going to do in 5 milliliter increments here, so we're going to have 5, 10, 15, 20, 25. So if we add, or if we have a pH of 1, or we're going to start with a pH of 1, and we're going to go up to 2.7 when we add 24 milliliters. So that's going to be right around here. So our initial pH is going to gradually increase like this. Okay. Now, the third data point that we're going to ask is, what is the pH after adding 25.00 milliliters of NaOH? So what happens here is that our number of moles of H plus is going to equal our number of moles of OH minus. We call this the endpoint of the titration. And the pH is going to be dictated by our salt solution. In this case, the salt is NaCl. And if we have the conjugate of both a strong acid and a strong base, our pH is going to equal 7.0 in this case. Okay, so our three pH data points, we go from 1 to 2.7 by adding 24 milliliters of the base. But now when we add 25 milliliters, our pH is going to be 7. So we're going to see a dramatic jump in pH just like this. Okay? And when we hit this point right here, we're going to call this an equivalence point of the titration. And the equivalence point is where the moles of acid equal the moles of the base. Okay? So now, what's going to happen to our pH? And the fourth data point that we're going to look at is, what happens to the pH when we add 25.50 milliliters of NaOH? So this means that when we have 25.0 milliliters of 0.1 molar HCl, we have 2.500 millimoles of HCl. Here, if we have 25.50 milliliters of 0.1 molar NaOH, this means we have 2.550 millimoles of NaOH. So there are going to be 0.05 millimoles of NaOH in excess. We divide that by the total concentration, which is 50.50 milliliters. Remember, molarity is equal to millimoles divided by milliliters, and our concentration of sodium hydroxide is going to be 9.9 times 10 to the minus 4 molar. Okay, so that's going to equal our concentration of OH minus. So our pOH is going to equal 3.0, which means that our pH is going to equal 11. So just past the endpoint, we're going to go from a pH of 7 to a pH of 11. So if we look at this, if we have 25.5 milliliters, our value is going to go kind of off of this chart like this. So we have a very slow increase in pH, then we're going to hit the equivalence point and it's going to jump up like this, and then this curve is kind of going to flatten out as we add excess base. Okay, so down here in this curve we have a buffer region, then we're going to hit the equivalence point, and the equivalence point pH is going to be dictated by the salt. Then at the top of this curve the pH changes slowly beyond the endpoint. And this is a characteristic curve for an acid-base titration. And we can point out several regions in this curve. One, the pH before we add any base. Second, the pH after adding almost enough base to hit the endpoint. Third, the pH at the endpoint. And fourth, before we add any excess base. Okay, and during a titration, we're always going to add the base to the acid. Okay, and this kind of gives you a general overview of acid-base titrations with a strong acid, strong base titration. And in the next video, we'll cover what happens when we add a weak acid to a strong base.